What's going on, guys? Townflame HD here, and welcome to the 15th episode of the FIFA 17 Sunderland Career Mode. The support on this series has been fantastic. I want to thank you guys so much for that. Not going to dwell over it, but we're going to get into the episode now. Three games as usual. In the previous episode, though, we drew 0-0 against Stoke City. It was a frustrating game, but it was a draw nonetheless, so we're still unbeaten in that respect. It's a 2-0 win against West Brom. Armstrong and Anichi be getting those goals. 3 points on the board. We also lost 2-1 against Rochdale in the AFL Cup semi-final second leg. We stimmed that match, but we ended up losing 2-1. Mike Henderson getting Rochdale's two goals and Keita getting ours. However, with Keita scoring our goal, it was enough to get us into the final against Southampton on February 26th. So I'm looking forward to that. Hopefully we'll lift some silverware. It looks like we've got the Premier League in the bag, but I don't want to count our chickens just yet, so to speak. So we are sitting top of the Premier League table, 21 points clear of second place Chelsea. Our next game is against Oxford in the FA Cup fourth round at the Stadium of Light. I'll get into that in just a second, but I want to go through the transfers that we made over the course of the past two episodes. So we signed Marko Pjaca. I finally learned how to pronounce his name, the 21-year-old Croatian from Juventus, for $5 million plus Jermaine Defoe. We signed Kylian Mbappe from AS Monaco on a two-year loan and a future fee of £3 million. Looking forward to seeing how he develops. Never used him yet. And we've also signed DeAndre Yedlin from Newcastle United for £5 million plus Billy Jones. Now, I was looking to get rid of Billy Jones anyway, and DeAndre Yedlin was one of these right-backs that I've used for quite a few years now in FIFA, ever since he joined Seattle Sounders. Then he moved to Tottenham, and then obviously came to us on loan last season. And then this season, he obviously played for Newcastle. So I was looking forward to playing with him in this FIFA and see how well he develops or see how well he plays. I'll give a debut to him and Pjaca, like a full debut to him and Pjaca in this episode, as Marcus Rashford wants to play the next game. So we're going to get into the game now against Oxford, and let's see if we can progress through the next round. And here we have it, guys. This is the lineup that we're going with. DeAndre Yedlin is in there at right back. Pjaca is down the left hand side. Berini's moved up into striker. Armstrong's obviously been promoted to the first team. So, team's looking strong. I'm liking the look of the team. I'll probably end up replacing Manone at some stage next season or just at the start of next season. But to be fair, I'm looking to only play the one season and then. Thanks for that. I'll mute that. really need to remember to fucking mute my computer. But I'm looking to play the one season and see how well we do. Because by the time we get one season over with, I expect FIFA 18 to come out. And then once FIFA 18 comes out, I might do a weekly series of the Sunderland Career Mode, getting back into the Premier League and then winning the Premier League or getting Champions League football from there. So we'll see how well that goes, but that's a general idea. So we're getting into the game now against Oxford, and let's go for those. Well, I was going to say let's go for those 3 points, but they're not in the Prem. Let's go for a win and get through the next round in the Cup. Over the top for Duncan Watmore. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch. He's kept it in. Duncan Watmore's kept that in. It's beautiful play. Rashford's at the back post, but it's good. It's very well defended by Oxford. But only a corner could have been worse. All right, Moreno. Get your cross in. Oh, who was going to try back for... Ooh. Right, Pjaca. Over the top. Oh! Yes! Jason Denial, good finish. But, yo, who was going to try an overhead kick at the back post there? Was that actually Denial? Cross comes in from Pjaca. Rashford manages to get an overhead kick on it, but... Yo, was that Denier at the back post? Like, gonna... Yo, mad. Anyway, we're 1-0 up through some extravagance. But, well done, Jason Denier. Good finish, 1-0. Berini, over the top for Rashford. Marcus Rashford. He's inside, that's a pen. But like, that was a terrible challenge. So falls to Berini. And I've skied it. I've actually skied it. That didn't all go.
Well, everybody expecting that one to find the back of the net. What a glorious opportunity wasted.
That's a very bad penalty. Not even working the goalkeeper. Why?
No, it's a shocker. You won't be on penalties next week, I would imagine.
I didn't mean to hold the button down. I meant to tap it. Safe to say, Burundi's not taking another penalty. That's going to get changed. So I've made a quick substitution. I've took Burundi off and I've brought Kylian and Mbappe on just to see if we can grab a goal or two. See what happens. Pjaca. Marko Pjaca! He's hit the fucking bar! Ndong to Mbappe.
Nicely played through ball.
Back to Ndong. Back to Mbappe. To Moreno. Moreno's right foot. Falls to Rodwell. He finds Mbappe. Mbappe! Yes! Kylian Mbappe, what a finish. Beautiful. Oh, Rodwell with a cheeky little reverse pass inside. Good, excellent first touch by a very low-rated Kylian Mbappe. And it's a very cool finish into the bottom corner. I love that. That's a 2-0 win. Despite Burundi missing his penalty, it looks like we're through. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. We have won 2-0. Goals coming from Denayer and Mbappe. Burundi missed his penalty, which was unfortunate. It could have easily been a 3-0 win. It could have easily been more if we put our chances away. But it's a 2-0 win. We're through at the next round. I'll see you in the next game. We've received a transfer offer for Linton Gooch, guys. It's a short-term loan to Exeter City, so it's only like 3 months. Got to go ahead and accept that, because Gooch is currently surplus to our requirements at the moment. So he has gone. We also received 90 grand for going through the next round. Well, thanks. Transfer offer for Marcus Rashford. £26 million from Inter Milan. Rejecting that straight away because Rashford is one of our top strikers at the moment. I have no one to replace him, even if we did sell him. And I'm not looking to sell him, so reject. And our second game of the episode, guys. It is against Crystal Palace at Selhurst Park. So we've gone with the first team, or I'm going with the first team. It looks like Armstrong's gone up again. Baldy Keita's gone up again. Januzaj's gone up. It looks like quite a few players have actually grown by a point. I'll have a look through the actual squad in between this, like in between the next game, just to see who has actually grown. So yeah, we're going to get into this game now, and it's in the Prem. So 3 points? Question mark. Januzaj up against Papa Suarez, who had that accident this season, and I hope that he has recovered. Anichibi. Keita. Van Aanholt gets his cross in. Armstrong's waiting for it. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's fucking beautiful. It's beautiful. We just can't stop scoring. We can't stop winning in this series. I don't know why. Like, am I that good at FIFA? Like, just once, I'd like a bit of a challenge. It's on legendary difficulty, for fuck's sake. But it's a splendid cross by Van Aanholt down the left-hand side. Straight on Armstrong's forehead. It's 1-0. Same substitution as before, except this time I'm taking an Anichibi off and I'm bringing Mbappe on. Mbappe has just gone up. I've noticed he's gone from a 70 rating to a 71. So, like I say, I'm going to have a look at people's growth in between this episode and the next. Kirchhoff, good tackle. Armstrong releases Mbappe, who releases Baldy Keita. Keita with a turn inside, finds Armstrong, finds Kirchhoff. It's 2-0. It's beautiful. It is. Like, that was beautiful play, I'm not going to lie. It was a good pass there, a good turn inside there by Keita. Finds Armstrong, finds Kirchhoff. Sweaty goal, 2-0. I'll do anything to get a goal. You guys know this. Kirchhoff. Catamol, Mbappe, turns, runs against Suarez, passes Suarez. That's a pen. That's another pen. Come on.
Risky going in like that.
Very good. It was a good run then by Mbappe, and it was definitely inside the box. No question about it. It's a pen. And we have Armstrong taking this one. And he just rolls it in the bottom corner. It's 3-0. So we'll leave it at that. 3 points. I'm happy with that.
Yeah, he's a man you can depend on in these situations because he does keep.
Very happy with that. Confident penalty, 3-0. And that is full time, guys. We've won 3-0 against Crystal Palace. Goals coming from Armstrong and Kirchhoff, I think it was. Yep, two from Armstrong, one from Kirchhoff. So it's 3 points on the board. Hopefully that puts an even bigger gap between us and Chelsea. Anything develops between this game and the next, I'll let you know. If not, see you then. So I'm just looking at the squad report here, and I decided to go through, you know, the players to see who's grown. So it looks like Pickford's gone up by one. Manquillo's gone up by two. Conan, Djilabodji haven't gone up. Van Aanholt's gone up. Januzaj's gone up by two. Kirchhoff's gone up by one. Catamol stays the same. Balde, Keita's gone up by two. I knew an HB wouldn't. But Armstrong's gone up by five. Wow. Okay. Mbappe's gone up by one. Rashford by three. Pjaca hasn't gone up yet. Watmore's gone up by one. Yedlin hasn't gone up yet. Moreno's gone up by one. Rodwell's gone up by one. Beedling, Greenwood, all gone up. Like, so I'm happy with how things are going with the squad. Sorry, I'm kind of not in the middle. But Denier's gone up by two, and Dong's gone up by one. McNair's gone up. Mika, for some reason, even though he hasn't actually played a game yet. O'Shea's gone down, which we expected until he's 35. Barini's gone up. And obviously, Pienaar's gone down as well. So, Matthews has gone up. Interesting. He might be a decent little right back next season. That's if I decide to play a second season. But, oh, hello. £12 million free. Like, yeah, I'm not going to use Coates. So, actually, I don't know those stats, though. Slide and stand tackle, 85. I forgot about Coates. I actually forgot about him. But he's worth £12 million, so it might be worth investing in him. But anyway, that's pretty much how the squad's looking. So the squad is definitely growing. I'm happy with that. Our manager rating's 81. So we shall get into the last game now against Southampton, and let's go for 3 points. And here we have the final game of the episode, guys. It is Southampton at the Stadium of Light. First team again, so 3 points should be relatively easy, but we'll see what happens. Armstrong up against Virgil. It needs to be. Back into Armstrong. Beautiful. Fucking beautiful. Fucking beautiful. Love that. Ah, good 1-2 there. Good 1-2 player. That's what it takes to be champions. But the real Sunderland can't do this because they don't have me. And I know how to play football. But yeah, 1-0. I'm just being a dick. Armstrong. Keita. Keita. Armstrong. 2-0. Armstrong got in the way of Keita. Yet. Armstrong still managed to score the goal. Like, okay. Also, that was our 99th goal of the series. One more goal and we have 100. Like, I wonder who'll score it. Could be Armstrong. Could be Anichibi. Could be Keita. Could be Pickford. You never know. Alright, guys, substitution time. So I've taken Keita off and brought Pjaca on. I've taken Udicevic off and brought Mbappe on. So the referee's happy.
FA Cup fixture, Sunderland, they'll be hosting Crystal Palace.
You can't believe it's just not better. This is how we do it. Why the fuck have I got this song in my head? This is how we do it. Releases Pjaca. Pjaca has space to run. Marko Pjaca, 3-0. It's that easy. Good release by Cattenwall. He got his head up and looked. Got the ball through to Pjaca. Tiny little finish. It's 3-0. It's full time. And we win 3-0. We've scored exactly 100 goals in... well, in this series. Goals coming for two from Armstrong and one from Marko Pjaca. I'm very happy with this. So, I'll finish with the Premier League table in just a second, but the 3-0 win, I'm happy with that, and like I say, Pjaca got our 100th goal. That is a hell of a milestone, and we're only 15 episodes in. I'm going to turn down that contract extension you offered. I appreciate Brian H. Are you touting the piss? Feels he's too big for the team. Are you touting the piss? Are you genuinely taking the piss? Wow, okay. Fuck you then. Just thanks, Jordan. So this is the Premier League table at the end of the 15th episode, guys. We're sitting top still. 24 games played, 23-1-1 draw. We scored 67 goals in the Premier League, conceding 2, and sitting comfortably there on 70 points. 23 points ahead of Chelsea, which is surprising. So we've made up another 2 points on them in this episode. Like I said, so Chelsea are second on 47, City third on 41, Stoke have gone down to fourth on 39, and Spurs are fifth on 36. United are seventh, Liverpool are ninth, Arsenal are 13th, wow. And the bottom three remain the same of Leicester, Everton and Burnley. So if Leicester remain in the relegation zone and are eventually relegated, I may go in for Riyad Mahrez. Replace him with, you know, like Watmore, send Watmore out on loan for a season or two. As for Everton, I'd probably just grab Ademola Lookman, maybe Seamus Coleman to replace Manquillo, and Burnley's Burnley. So this is going to be the end of the episode. Thank you so very much for watching. Thank you for all the support that you've given me for the series. I'm really enjoying playing FIFA. I really do love playing FIFA in general. I may go for foot champs. I may do an ultimate team, you know, tournament or something. Let me know what you think of that in the comment section down below. I'm happy to bring that to you. So thank you so very much for watching. If you're new around here, hit that subscribe button. If you like the video and want to see some more, drop a thumbs up as well. It'd be greatly appreciated, and I'll see you guys later.